Hey guys, what's up? I'm at the Golden Gate Bridge and here's my friends. Hey, say hi to you! So here I am at the bridge, and the reason why I'm at the bridge is that I want to show you an origami model. Well, a couple days ago, I taught you how to fold this convertible car. Click right here for that video. And now, I'm going to show you how to fold the Golden Gate Bridge from the Golden Gate Bridge. And this was the idea of Charlie, the kid I just tutored a couple days ago. Thanks, Charlie. The Golden Gate Bridge. Want to learn how to fold it? You're ready, set, here goes.
Alright, so for this model, obviously I used a US $1 bill, but you could use a 3x7 rectangle, and I have a tutorial here for how to divide a square into two 3x7 rectangles. Alright, so for a bridge with the number 1s showing on the face side of the bill, let's begin face side down. So turn over and fold in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. This is a pretty complex model, so if you're new to folding, I don't recommend trying this model. But if you're up for the challenge, then let's continue. Let's fold this edge up to this edge. Make sure that it's exact. If you're using a 3x7 rectangle, don't worry, because none of the features on the dollar are used as guidelines. Okay, let's repeat. On this side, fold this edge to here. And unfold, and unfold. Okay, now we're going to reverse fold these flaps. So first, let's open here, and we're going to reverse this crease, just on this layer. So pinch it from the corner, pinch, 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 pinch. Notice how my finger is behind, providing support. Pinch, 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 right to here. And now push it in, and bring the two flaps together. Like that. And flatten. And let's repeat on this side. So open here, reverse the crease, pinch, 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 and bring the two flaps together. And flatten. Okay, let's turn over and fold this flap to the right and fold it back so that it's sticking straight up. And now we're going to squash it. So open the pocket, put your finger into the pocket and squash it so that this crease lands on this point right there. And flatten it. And let's repeat on this side. So fold it to the left and make it stick straight up in the air. And open the pocket and squash it. Make sure that when you squash it, it goes right to this point. Line the crease up so that it's centered and flatten. And rotate. Well, let's rotate. Let's turn it around like this and fold this edge up so that these points go up to these points. And flatten. And let's unfold and rotate. And now we're going to petal fold these two flaps. So let's start with this one. Open here, put your finger inside here, and we're going to fold right along this crease. So just on the top layer, fold along that whole crease. And squash it. And when we squash it, these two edges come together. And you want to make sure that the folds come right to this point. Make it all exact. And when it's super exact, then make all of those folds sharply. Okay, so there is one petal fold. That's what it looks like. Let's do the other petal fold. We're working on the pillars of the towers of the bridge. Okay, just make sure that all of these folds are exact because any error gets magnified as we go along. Now, let's fold these two flaps down. Alright, now let's fold this flap to the left and this flap to the right. And fold this flap up like this and make that fold go straight across and rotate. And now fold this edge to this edge and make sure that it's a perfect match. Make sure that the two edges match up perfectly. Okay, now let's fold this flap, or rather these two flaps over, and fold these two flaps over. And rotate. And now fold this flap up right on the existing crease and make it go all the way over here. And same thing on this side. So we're not flattening here yet. Okay, and now we're going to flip this corner behind. So in order to do that, you have to open up here just enough so that you can flip it behind. Like that. And let's flip this one behind. So open and flip it. And close it back. So this is 3D. Let's turn over right to left and fold this flap up on the existing crease. And when you fold it up, then you'll be able to flatten this corner and this corner. And when you make this fold, make sure that it aligns with these edges. Okay, so it's like this. Now turn over top to bottom and fold this flap up so that it aligns with this edge. And we're going to squash this flap. So open it. Squash it so that it becomes a square. And make sure that it comes right to this corner. Like that. And now fold this raw corner to this point. And open the pocket. it's like that. And now fold this edge up to this edge. So we're folding on this point. And let's repeat on this side. So first fold this flap up and open the pocket, squash it, and fold the flap up, open the pocket, and squash it, and fold this edge to here. Okay, let's turn over right to left and fold this edge up to this edge. And really be careful when making that fold that it aligns all the way along it. Exact, then you can make the fold sharp. All right, let's turn back over top to bottom. And now let's pull out this corner. I'm gonna zoom in so you see what I'm doing. Reach in and pull out the raw corner and flatten it like that and repeat on this side. Like that. Okay, now we're going to narrow the towers. So let's rotate and fold this front flap up. How far? Well, what you want, you want all of these edges to be aligned. I didn't do as good as I would have liked, but okay, good enough. So fold this front flap up. How far? You want to estimate thirds. In other words, we want this length to be equal to this length. And flatten that sharply. And now fold this flap up again, this time, so that this edge aligns with this edge and this crease. And this takes quite a lot of force and dexterity. And you want to try to make sure that that fold is parallel to this edge. Okay, and now fold this flap up again and pinch it tight so that it stays in place. So it's like that. So we narrowed this side of the pillar. Let's work on this side. So let's bring it up. Let's rotate and fold the flap up, estimating thirds. Make sure that that fold is parallel with this edge. And fold it up again. And now when you fold it up this time, just pay close attention that the fold aligns with the edge behind it. Like that, and same here. And fold it up. And there, one pillar is almost done. We still need to make the support foundation part. Okay, let's work on the other pillar. So let's rotate and fold this flap up, estimating thirds, and fold it up again. And fold it up again. And bring this flap up. Rotate. Fold it up once, twice, and thrice. Okay, so we have the outsides pretty much complete. Let's work on the inside. So first, let's fold it in half. And when you fold it in half, you want to make it really exact and make it sharp enough that you can see it later on, because we're going to use this fold as a landmark. And unfold. And now turn over and let's fold this flap up so that the fold goes through this corner, and we want the middle of the tower to align with this edge. Make sure that it perfectly goes through this point. Like that. And make that fold nice and sharp. Okay, and same on this side. So fold it up right on this point and make the tower align with this edge and make the fold. And now unfold these two flaps. Now we're going to reverse this crease and this crease. So reach in and grab onto it and pinch along the diagonal crease, just on the front layer. So it's like that. You can just leave it in three dimensions. And same on this side. Make sure that that fold goes perfectly to this point. Okay, so it should look like this. Now turn it over a little bit and push the middle point in. Like that. And now fold this edge to the middle crease. And make that fold extend from this point to this crease, like that. And let's do the same thing on this side. So now we're folding this edge to here. And you can push this in, like that. Fold it till it comes to the crease. And now turn over, and we're going to repeat on this side. So fold this edge to the middle crease. And now when you fold it, you can flatten here. Notice how this edge does not line up with this edge when it's flattened. But I guess this edge pretty much lines up with this edge. Okay, and let's repeat on this side. Okay, so we're looking a little bit more like the Golden Gate Bridge, but we have all of this extra paper here. So let's try to reverse fold that, or rather sink it. Let's fold the flap up right on this edge. And make that fold nice and sharp. There should be a little pleat right in there. Now unfold it and open here and open here and refold it on that same fold so that the pleat goes from this point all the way to this point. And now take this edge right here and fold along it. Like that. And same thing on this side. Pinch, pinch, pinch. And now bring these two flaps down. So it's kind of like a paper airplane fold. Like that. All right, let's repeat on the other side. So turn over and fold this up like this. Make that fold nice and sharp. And unfold, open here, bring the fold up, and make that fold so that it goes from this point to this point, and fold along this edge, and same on this side. And fold the two flaps down. Oh, make sure that you don't lose the pleat. So it's like that, and fold it down there, and there. Okay, that's looking pretty good. But we have an extra point here. We don't want three, we just want two. So, fold this down. And unfold it. And now open here, and we're going to wrap the paper over this edge. So just open it and wrap it over and squash, flatten it. And now, open here and wrap the paper over the edge and flatten. So it's like that. So we have these two flaps. Let's hide them behind this edge and behind this edge. All right, now let's repeat on the other side. So turn over and fold the flap down. And unfold it and open here, fold the paper over this edge and flatten and open here and fold it over this edge and flatten and hide these two flaps. Okay, almost done. We just need to narrow it a little bit more in the center. So this is how to do it. Open here. And just fold the flap inside. of it like that. Inside, like that. And turn over and repeat on this side. Fold this flap inside. And flatten. And when we turn over, it's almost done. We just need to fix it up here in case those folds are coming undone. And if you like it like this, you're done. But if you want it to stand, if you want to make a foundation here so that it can stand, then this is what you want to do. Turn over and I need to fix this up because it came undone. Okay. So it's like this. Fold this point up so that it's like this. And now unfold it. Open the flap. And squash it right on the existing fold. So this wraps around this edge, this wraps around that edge, and it's like this. Okay, now let's repeat on this side. So fold this flap up like this. And get this thing in focus. Okay, that's better. And unfold. And now open the flap. Fold it over this edge. And open this flap. I wish that my fingers were a little bit smaller right about now. Almost got it. Okay, I think I got it. Well, that was tough. Okay, so there it is. And now we're going to make a fold. Let's do that from the other side. So turn over and let's fold the base of these towers so that the fold goes between this point and this point. And when you do that, you can let the raw corner swing out. I guess I should zoom in so that you can see this. Folding right on those corners. Like that. And then you can fold it back so that the base of it is perpendicular to the face of the bridge. And let's do the same thing on this side. Okay, so these two flaps will act as a stand for the bridge. So it's like this. And you can just kind of adjust them. Well, this actually stands pretty well just like that. But if you need to, you just need to fiddle with these two flaps to make sure that they align. That they're in the same plane. And there we have it. And it's all done. And it's not really an action model, but I guess if you want, you can. The action is that the convertible can drive over the bridge and you ask your audience, what is this called? and they say, driving over the bridge, and you say, no, it's $6. Get it? $6 is the toll to cross the Golden Gate Bridge. When I do that joke for the kids, usually they don't get it, but the parents get a kick out of it because they get the joke. Oop, there's another $6. That's kind of silly. Let's see, what else can we do? Well, it can also be a monster. Yeah, a monster bridge. Open up here, and you can even use it as a finger puppet. If you open here, you can put your index finger on this point and your thumb on this flap. And now it's a chomping bridge. It likes to eat cars. Only convertibles. It has very fine taste buds. I'm just kidding, I don't know. Alright, so there you have it. Hope you guys were able to fold that. I know it's a pretty extensive model, pretty challenging, but hope you're up for the challenge, and if not, well, maybe if you try it again, you'll manage to make it successfully. So I wish you guys well, and have a nice drive. Vroom! Bye-bye!
And now it's time to cross the bridge. Here goes. Like a picture together, and then you can take a picture of mine.
Yeah.